Hello and welcome to We the People. After Prime Minister Modi's statements on Independence Day, his address at the UN, and even his Mann Ki Baat radio address this morning, it's pretty clear. A ban or a phasing out at least of some single-use plastics from the 2nd of October, the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, is inevitable. What does this mean for the average Indian? What will it mean for businesses and consumers? How hard will it be to implement this? Can you ban something when an alternative is not available? And what is the use of a ban if we don't have an effective waste disposal system? Is a ban on plastics necessary, or do we just need to start using it properly? These are tough questions. They must be asked because we cannot afford to fail when it comes to saving our planet. And in the firing line tonight, we have a panel of experts who have spent their lives and built their careers in this field. We have Bharti Chaturvedi. She is a writer, an environmentalist, and she is the founder of Chintan, that is a non-profit that manages over 30 tons of solid and electronic waste every day in the Delhi region. It works with waste pickers to create wealth from waste. We have Dr. Vamanacharya from the BJP, a former chairperson of the Karnataka State Pollution Control Board, also a composter manufacturer, something not many may know about him. We have Dr. Vijay Habu. He is an adjunct professor at the Institute of Chemical Technology, ICT Mumbai, also a consultant for the plastics industry. From Himachal Pradesh, one of the first states in India to impose a ban on plastic bags way back in 2003, we have Tikinder Panwar, former deputy mayor of Shimla. Vikram Sharma, CEO of Baidyanath Group, to speak for the consumer goods companies, many of whom are spooked ahead of an impending ban on single-use plastics. And Dr. Naveen Dang, a government-nominated member of the Medical Council of India, and he's going to also speak for on disposable plastics in the health profession. And we have Mr. Jayesh Rambia, representing the All India Plastic Manufacturers Association. Bharti Chaturvedi, first to you, single-use plastics were once considered a boon. Now we're saying they're a sinister menace. Which is it? You work with an organization that says waste can cure, can fight poverty, can fight child labor, can fight gender inequality in the country. So you tell us.
So only the right kind of, first of all, the planet is completely in an emergency situation. I think I don't have to say it. We have a lot of young people here today, and they are leading us to opening our eyes.
Correct.
So I don't think we can actually go on producing waste with the logic that it fights poverty. What Chintan says is that you can use, now that there's waste, if there's reduced waste, we can use it to create jobs to handle it properly. Having said that, we are finding one of the great phenomenons of our modern age is that, you know, we put products out into the environment first, and then science always catches up later, whether you look at DDT or whether you look at plastics. Yeah. And so we're catching up with plastics today. I mean, some other day we might catch up with some other material. And what we're really realizing is that there's a problem with microplastics, which is now the new science that we're all looking at globally, not just me, but loads and loads of scientists and people right. like that Chintan works with. And we're really finding that it's not that much of a boon, but it's also a very complicated kind of a complex tragedy, because, you know, our salt, 83% of water has plastic, drinking yes. water. You know, IIT Bhubaneswar said that we had microplastics in our salt. So where do we go? You can't totally deplasticize. And there are lots and lots of challenges. You know, here we have Vikram right here, but there, I mean, he represents one of those industries that's kind of stuck. You need more R&D. What are the alternatives? But having said that, there are loads of alternatives for some things, and we need to start somewhere. And I don't
believe. So we need to start somewhere. So you are for a ban. You think that is the solution. Single-use plastics. You expect this announcement that is made, that there will be, there should be an announcement made on the 2nd, and you are in favor of it, technically.
I'm not in favor of only a ban. I think, you know, we've banned many things. We've banned people from, you know, female feticide, but women still have a terrible, terrible unequal position.
And over 28 states already have a ban.
So what we really need is a ban plus incentives, financial and other, and disincentives, and finding ways to create new jobs out of alternatives.
All right, Dr. Vamanacharya, you know, you're from the BJP. Prime Minister Modi has now trained his guns on single-use plastic. You're with the BJP, you will be towing the party line. But I hope you can be a little candid tonight. You own a compost company, so you're living proof that there can be wealth in waste. What is your view on this impending ban on single-use plastics? Is it implementable? We've just said that at least 28 states already have this ban. So why should it be any different now?
First is, this one-time usable plastic is only a small portion of the total plastic world that is there.
Correct.
Today, right from the pipeline that supplies water to you, right on the road on which you walk, tar roads are also made of plastic these days. Lot of plastic is being used there. You cannot live with plastic, but the plastic that is being used for shopping, for day-to-day use, is causing hell lot of a problem, like throwing on the road. You put some food item and throw it. The food item smells, or animals, especially cows and all that, eat that plastic along with the food there, and it chokes. This type of plastic is there in rivers, in fields, in seas, in the stomach of the many animals here. It has entered everywhere. So something has to be done to prevent this plastic from entering into the use of the living beings here and there. Not only that, this plastic is, the look itself is aghast. It is very cheap, so people use it quite frequently. There is no need to reuse it because the cost is so less that even a small vendor on the road gives it almost
free. As Bharati said, we don't need to explain that now to anyone. So you tell me, is this implementable? We understand single-use plastics, you're saying must be banned. Is it implementable?
It is implementable because here in Karnataka, we have seen that this ban has been there for last almost 3-4 years. The Pollution Control Board officers go at the site of manufacturing, at the site of selling, at the site of disposal, and put pressure on them not to use them. The plastic use has come down to such an extent, to a very large extent it has come down, because the collection and reuse of such thin, very thin plastic, less than 15-20 micron, is almost disappearing from the market today in Karnataka. This will happen everywhere. This is only a first step. We will have to work on what else can be done to prevent this plastic usage in future days. It is not impossible.
Sir, this is also a state you're talking about where we frequently hear that the lakes are on fire. There are these mounds of garbage that are constantly burning in the heat. Tikinder Panwar, please come in over here, because Mr. Acharya is saying that use of plastics has completely ended in Karnataka. You are from a state which implemented one of the first bans in 2003. Did it work?
Yeah, to some extent I would say it worked, but I think before going to that, I think it's, the so-called ban that we're expecting on 2nd October, it's more of a rhetoric. And this whole argument that, look, I'm going to do everything, main hu jo bhi sab kuch karunga yahan par, I think we have to get rid of it, because it can be done only in a phased manner. I mean, at least from some states, they must learn some examples. And Himachal also, there was in a phased manner, and lots of excise was done. And where are the stakeholders? I mean, if he has to do everything, where are the industry groups?
Who is the he you're talking about?
Sorry?
Who is the he you're talking about?
The Prime Minister.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm speaking about the Prime Minister. So I think, A, it has to be done in a phased manner. And for also, and some practical things. For example, in Delhi, tomorrow all of a sudden we say we are going to get rid of your milk packets.
Correct.
So if that has to be done, at least 50% glass bottle milk should have been supplied by now. All of a sudden, if you get rid of milk packets, what is going to happen? Will people march on to the booth and then collect milk? So I think it's better said than done. That's one point. Two, why I bring in the whole question of stakeholders, we are completely, for the ban. That has to happen. But bring in the stakeholders here. Hmm. What about, take for example, your pearl bed bottles. I remember this famous anecdote we used to share in Simla. We said we'll ban the pearl pet bottles. And then one of, I don't name the industry, one of the Coke giants came and said, don't do that. Why? We have a very tiny state. They said, no, the consumption is some 90 lakhs in Himachal. Just the cola bottles. And it's not just the consumption, but the cascading the effect that is going to happen. So if that excise is to take place, that excise has to take place from the supply side also. Why don't you do a simple thing? Charge cola bottles 1 rupee and let that rupee be given to the government. Right. And then through that government, bring in various stakeholders, various agencies, various social groups, and bring in a mechanism for a complete solid waste management. Why can't you do that? So I think it is more of a rhetoric. And already, as you've said, some of the states are already implementing the ban.
You know, you've touched on two important points. One, solid waste management. Yeah. And two, the elephant in the room, the economy. Dr. Vijay Habu, the single-use plastic ban, is this a disguised admission by the government, this government, previous governments, that they have failed to put in place adequate garbage disposal mechanisms? And without that, nothing is going to work.
I'm glad you're moving from, you know, just one agency, because in this waste management, there are three agencies or three corners of a triangle: the citizens, the local bodies, and the industry.
Yes.
It's a very lazy way of saying, say no to plastics. It's very, kids are impressionable and they say no to plastics. The real message should be, what they should be taught is, say no to littering. Assuming tomorrow a material instead of plastic, something else comes up, the tendency and the behavior of littering is going to continue. So another 10 years, a new batch of kids is going to come with placards saying, say no to that material. We need to train our kids to say no to littering, not to say no to plastics. Plastics came about, and children need not be alarmed by these things, by alarmist theories that they're microplastics. These are big words. You can scare off people very easily. Plastics came about as a remedy to the existing materials, the deficiencies and the inadequacies of the existing materials then there. Like glass, metal, paper. Because there were deficiencies, plastics came in as a remedy. In science, in the journey of science, the know-how always comes out, and the know-why follows. It's always the case, whether it is anything, any food technology or armory, anything. The know-how happens first, the know-why catches up later. That is how science always works.
So you're saying that regardless of the material...
In the case of microplastics, it's very important, because, you know, people will get scared by these big words. Yes, microplastics, there have been recent reports, but there have been equally vehement rebuttals by WHO, none less than WHO, which says that there is nothing to worry about. Let's take an empirical example. Plastics have been with us for 50, 60 years. If microplastics were causing any harm, by now, after 50, 60 years of ingestion, there would have been some alarming problems. None of that thing has happened.
Well, we have a doctor here, but I don't think we're here to refute whether these studies are true or false. The fact is, microplastics are being found in our diets, in our water, and it is affecting our health. And that is because of what you're saying, littering. No.
It is not convinced that, you know, we do not know whether they affect our health or not, because the water is already, even the groundwater is infested with heavy metals, with phthalates.
So are we now condoning pollution?
All I'm saying is, our bodies, we are already subjected to a whole host of pollutants.
But so plastics, add one more. Let plastics continue.
Plastics are a physical contaminant.
I cannot make this, Dr. Dang. We have Dr. Dang here, but I cannot make this an argument about, you know, the climate skeptics and the non-climate skeptics. That's not what this show is about. But it is about a plastic ban. So I'm going to stick to the point that you raised first. You are saying, this problem is not going to go away. We'll be back in 20 years in the same We the People set, with a different audience, a different generation. If Indians continue to litter, then today we're arguing about plastics, tomorrow we'll be arguing about glass or metals or whatever the alternative is. So Bharati Chaturvedi, you've been disagreeing while doctor was speaking here. So I want to come across to you. But first, let me ask the audience. You just heard Dr. Vijay Habu saying that, I mean, basically what he's saying is that Plastigiri is the new Gandhigiri. Anybody, do you have a point of view on this? It's now fashionable to oppose the use of plastics.
Respected panelist and NDTV personnel and my dear environmental activist. First of all, I introduce myself. I'm Sumant Sekhar. I'm an environmental activist as the member of an NGO also. आजकल हम लोग एक इश्यूज़ पे, करंट इन्वायरमेंट इश्यूज़ पे हम लोग काम करते हैं. देयर इज़ एनजीओ लक्ष्य, सोसाइटी फॉर सोशल इन्वायरमेंटल डेवलपमेंट, एंड आई एम द मेंबर ऑफ दैट. तो एक करंट स्टेटस पे हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं. जो भी इश्यूज़ आती है, लाइक वाटर एक्टिविटीज़, जो मोदी जी का भी आगे सपना है, एंड प्लास्टिक बैन के, सिंगल यूज प्लास्टिक पे चल रहा है. तो ये इशूज़ हैं देश में, काफ़ी सर ने भी बोला, मैम ने बोला, ये इश्यूज बहुत क्रिटिकल है. लाइक पेट बोतल के लिए सर ने बोला, तो अभी जस्ट हमने पेट बोतल के जो 90% रिसाइकिल हो रहा है, कुछ स्टेट में 200 ml के नीचे वाले पेट बोतल को बैन कर दिया जा रहा है और ऊपर को उसको छोड़ दिया जा रहा है. तो उसका एक रीज़न समझ में नहीं आया. अगर ये इन्वायरमेंटली ख़राब है तो पूरे को बैन करो अगर आपको लगता है ये हो. बट इट इज़ 90% रिसाइकलेबल और 10% जो रिसाइकिल नहीं हो रहा है उसका एक रीज़न है अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड कलेक्शन, दैट इज़ द डिस्पोजल कलेक्शन. इस पर हमारी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अभी काम भी कर रही है. जस्ट एक NGTs के इशू पे भी गया था मैं.
So you're saying we don't need a ban, we need proper waste disposal,
yes, littering,
we need collection littering. To make sure this is recycled. That's what you're saying.
Yes.
Anyone wants to respond? You?
Hello, I'm
what
just,
Dr. Habu said.
I'm totally agreed with sir, as he said that the ban should be not, but we have to come with the precautions. The sir said ki, the people.
Dr. Habu?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, huh,
he said we have to control the littering. So we can't simply ban. So we have to come with the precautions first.
Okay. Bharti, go ahead. I know you were disagreeing, so just give us your point before I move on.
I'll be really brief. I think if you look at it, firstly, I mean, I don't think young people are scared of anything. They're not scared of climate change. They're marching on the roads and making us march with them. So this is not a generation that's scared of the big
And they're
big
very
problems.
Well informed, you think?
Yeah, I think so. I think they're well informed and I think they're open to being better informed. I think that's important.
You agree? What would you say to Dr. Habu? I heard you saying you're well informed.
So I am Manisha and I'm from 9is9. So like because we are well informed, that's why we are here to talk. And about children are scared and all. Yeah, we are scared about our present. Because of this climate emergency, not because of being scared ki bachcho ko ye nahi batana chahiye ye nahi. You should tell them the true information. Yes, about plastic, don't forget that ki plastic ko 2011 mein ban kar diya tha. Par kuch nahi hua usse bhi.
To is time kya farak hogi? Why will things be different?
That's the big question that जब 2011 में बैन करके कुछ नहीं हुआ तो इस बार क्या बैन करना चाहते हैं आप?
नहीं, आप लोग प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हो ना, आप स्टूडेंट्स हो, यू आर गिविंग अप गोइंग टू स्कूल ऑन फ्राइडे और आप रोड पे जाकर प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हो. आप यहाँ पे पोस्टर्स ले आए हो. डॉक्टर अबू कह रहे हैं कि आप लोग प्रोटेस्ट करते हो और फिर वही प्लास्टिक जहाँ पे ये प्लैकार्ड सब रोड पे फेंक कर चले जाते हो, तो फिर क्या बदलेगा?
नो, वी डोंट. एंड द बिग थिंग दैट वी वांट आवर कंट्री टू डिक्लेयर द क्लाइमेट इमरजेंसी बिकॉज The time is running up. As we all are aware that we have only 10 or 11 years. For you guys, your future, your half life has gone. But for us...
Really, correct. You have more at stake. But what Dr. Habu is saying is you have to
really
be the change.
Half is gone.
And he's saying it's fashionable now to protest about climate change.
We children are campaigning to reduce plastic. But the cooperators, what are they doing to reduce plastic?
Who are the cooperators?
Okay, good point, and I'm glad you raised that. And you put your hand up to speak on your own, the youngest here, and speaking more than others are. But I want to, all right, let's just move to Kinda Panwar. You raised a very important point, which was the economy, right? As this young lady said over here, we are sitting on a ticking time bomb. The clock is ticking. We cannot, as Greta Thunberg says, it is time to panic. We have to take on climate change. But ironically, the time back home, we're facing an economic slowdown. So that is a challenge for this government. Is this the time to call for a ban on plastics? That's the reality one has to keep in mind as we go into the 2nd of October. So Vikram Sharma, FMCG companies estimate that there's going to be an overall escalation in packaging costs.
Absolutely.
Come in over here.
Okay, I want to first make it clear that yes, I do agree that plastic needs to be banned, but in a systematic and a phased out, sensible sort of a manner, not ad hoc, that all of a sudden just ban everything, because that will not work. My friend Arjun Sharma, for instance, has made his mall, Select City, work completely plastic free, and I completely support that. But I want everybody to understand one more point. What are the alternatives? One is glass, right? Now you must remember that glass has a higher carbon footprint than plastic. Glass is a very complex thing, and also in the 70s, I think, when the Industrial Revolution happened and people started switching from glass to plastic, a lot of pollution was stopped even back then because of the carriage that would otherwise have been required to transport glass from one place to the other. The other alternate, and also you must remember that people are littering, right? We have to stop that. But then imagine, right now they are throwing plastic bottles. Now imagine throwing glass bottles everywhere. And imagine the repercussions of that. Hmm. The other alternative to plastic is aluminium, which is made from bauxite. And that also leads to a lot of problems in the environment when it's being made. And there are lots of issues about whether it's being made ethically or not. Okay. And lastly,
so the carbon footprint, Bharati Chaturvedi, please come in here, because this is an argument you hear a lot. Plastic bags require less energy to produce and recycle. You know, everybody's saying use cloth bags nowadays instead of these single-use plastics. There are studies that show that you have to use a cloth bag 104 times in order for it to, you know, have the same environmental effect as a plastic bag, which is not going to happen on the ground. You've written a book on this, right? Poly bags, the enemy within. You say there are alternatives.
So firstly, I don't believe that every alternative has to be the exact replica of the plastic bag. You don't need straws. If you're trusting the beverage that you're drinking and the hygiene of the place, why do you need any other kind of straw? For example, I'm just giving you an example.
Yeah.
And so I think we have to dematerialize, because, you know, waste and plastics are a part of the larger climate emergency.
Use less, consume less, and have proper waste
disposal. So I would rephrase, you know, I appreciate that what Vikram's saying, that let's do it in a phased manner. You know, of course we should do it, but we also have extended producer responsibility. So we have to get that
extended producer responsibility. Yeah. Vikram, please come in over here. For many years, for decades, the FMCG companies, you've enjoyed profits. Plastics has been so cheap to produce that at that point of time we didn't see prices go down. Now you're complaining that prices are going to go up because you may have to switch to glass or aluminium. It sounds a bit disingenuous.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that you just have to know that glass, aluminium and paper, you know, you have to understand that are they the sensible and the right alternatives to plastic? Like people say switch to paper bags. Do you realize that the amount of deforestation that happens because of that? The trees that are being grown, you must hear this, the nation must hear this, the trees that are being grown to support the paper industry are not being allowed to survive long enough, which is again affecting climate change and things like that.
Okay, Tikinder, you're disagreeing. The industry taken responsibility?
No, that's what I said
all
initially.
These years. Have industries done anything about recycling
was saying about
themselves?
The EPR, actually this is the example that I gave. Why don't you charge 1 rupee per cola bottle
and allow this money to, why should I pay
it to go to the government? Why doesn't the cola company takes that responsibility as part of the EPR, and then maybe we can create many conjunctions in between? But I think as far as the paper recycling are concerned, take for example in Himachal what we did. Actually, your paper comes from your newspapers. I mean, there's a whole lot of people, bunch of people who are engaged in this industry, very small industry, where they manufacture those paper bags in their home. And they're working. They're working for vegetables. They're working for N number of things, even for dals and all that stuff.
They're working for, dry dals?
Yeah, of course, dry dals.
We have
a
restauranter here, right? Ishan Goel, you're a restauranter. Please come in over here. We have Mr. Tikinder saying that there are alternatives. Paper, why can't we use paper? It's been used in Shimla.
As a restauranteur, I have already switched to from plastic, single-use plastics to paper products, but they have a cost implication. Plastic is, well, paper product is almost 300% more expensive than your plastic goods. Yeah. But still, the problem is with waste generation.
First and foremost, why have you made this switch?
300% means what? Maybe from 5 paisa to 15 paisa.
No.
No, how much
no,
is the
no,
cost?
No. From a paper, non-woven bag is 1 rupee, 10
See,
paisa, 20 paisa.
See, newspaper doesn't cost much. I mean, that's my point. I mean, you have a newspaper, there's a raddi wala, there's a whole, actually, I mean, this exercise comprises of lots of people. So raddi gets collected from the raddi, I mean, they manufacture those. I mean, where does the cost?
No,
hardly any cost.
What happens to the raddi? Raddi bag goes to, you know, there's a newsprint, quality of paper is different. Let's not mix up. You know, there is a science to it. One paper, just because the word paper is used, doesn't mean one paper can be recycled into another. So we need to have, when you say there are alternatives, we need to be very wary about it. Is it functionally appropriate?
Of course, sir.
You are saying that, you know, for example, children are there in June, July, you will have your results out. How will you carry your mark sheets? In paper bags? When the rain is, you know, pouring down?
Maybe you know when you talk about
how did I carry it when I was when I you, was, there was when, never a plastic bag. What? We have always when, we when have you talk always about,
when you talk
milk
about alternatives
tin I mean tin canisters
you
used
know,
to come
Dr.
from Amritsar
Dr.
Dang
sends us all medical reports online now. I get them on email every time I go to him for a checkup.
Just one point. I mean there has to be a functional consideration to this thing. Just merely stating here is a bag of plastic versus here is a bag of paper or here is a bag of cloth. You can't
we
do
have
that.
To talk about the functional aspect. So please finish. First of all, tell us, why did you make the switch? Is it pressure from the government?
There is of course pressure from the government. There are authorities which are on random checks across the markets.
Which is a good thing?
If they're informed enough, if they know what is banned and what is not banned.
Why can't you be informed and you be a change maker yourself? Because we've talked about how every individual has to take their own step. Why
Definitely.
Do you need the government to pressurize
See,
you?
See, we are trying to make the switch from plastic to paper or any other alternative as fast as possible. But there are not solutions, which there
you
are
don't have alternatives?
Alternatives to certain things like packing hot food, liquid items. Products with shelf life, which doesn't have that airtight capability. Paper will never have that kind of capability.
So how does, out of curiosity, like now if I order a curry, how would you send that? Because of flavor, it's wet, a paper would absorb it.
Right.
And
so what we have done is we've switched it to a paper which is coated with PE. It's a food grade coating. Yeah, it's a food grade coating.
So it's plastic. Coated with plastic.
Yeah, it's plastic. It's plastic coating, but it's a food grade plastic. It dissolves into water. That's what they claim, but I'm not sure if it is true or not.
Okay, so this is more expensive, and who's going to pick up the cost?
The consumer has to eventually.
But forget the cost. Look at the deception.
Right.
You are from the outside, you want it to be seen as paper, but inside there is plastic, and this composite makes it even difficult to recycle. If it was plain paper, it is easy to recycle. If it was plain plastic, it is easy to recycle. But when you combine the two, it makes life difficult.
So which is why we need to have these discussions. If we're going to go in for a ban, what are the alternatives?
Just one example, very relevant. We had huge floods and rains in Mumbai, and when in distress, what do you airdrop? Glass bottles with water?
Absolutely.
What comes, comes to the rescue? It's the relief material first goes in the plastic.
Keep plastic for the relief, not for normal times. And
keep plastic for the relief, not for everything.
Who is going to produce it if the factories are shut for 11
I agree,
months?
It has to be in a phased manner.
Ishan, I want to ask you, you're saying you're going to pass this cost on to the consumer?
Definitely. I would have to pass a certain amount of that cost to the consumer.
Okay, who's willing to respond to this? Here.
Yeah, so
do you like to order in food, which is an industry that's hugely growing in India?
Sometimes yes, but it always comes in plastic. But I'm also making another point here.
Will you respond to this? Otherwise, I'll get somebody else and then you can make your point. Ishan is saying, restaurants are saying that they are willing to make the switch to an alternative.
See, it's obviously,
the price is going to go up and you
expensive.
Are going to have to pay.
It's obviously expensive. There are a lot of materials, alternatives available. If we search on Amazon and order something, they come. They come wrapped in plastic.
Yes.
So here is the hypocrisy of the entire industry. So they have turned this plastic menace into a place to make profit for themselves. And this entire water-soluble plastics, we don't know. There is not enough research and development in India. So that has to come foremost. Enough research and development and huge government investment.
Excellent.
Because the corporate sector is never going to take responsibility. There are laws the Lays is manufacturing something, the plastic they are generating, that has to be, a channel has to be made so that the plastic comes to them and they recycle it.
Yeah.
But they never does it. So there has to be government investment to reduce this cost.
Yeah.
All right. So the important, as she mentioned over here, Amazon delivers something, it's all packed in 20 layers of bubble wrap, but the convenience that you have is that you can sit at home on your computer, place an order, and it comes straight to you. Are you willing to give up that convenience?
So if you're asking for a convenience, I think you have to pay a price for it at the end. Now, as Mr. Vikram
said,
the air
that you breathe and the water that you drink, that's a price that you're willing to pay?
You're paying the extra price for the alternative, which the company says that if they find the alternative, then they, the consumer has to pay the price, as he said. And as Mr. Vikram said, that everything has to be on the phase-wise. Say no to plastic is very simple term. Say no to plastic. why don't we emphasize on recycling the plastic, whatever is already there? So the first step is, has to be the segregation of the waste, which is not happening in India still at the last stage. First, we start with the segregation of the waste.
Segregation is totally happening. What are you saying? You have,
ma'am, it's still at the very initial phases. No, it's not happening in all over Delhi. No, it's not true. No,
you're talking of source segregation. I'm talking of the millions of people who are hyper-segregating your plastic.
Ma'am, why the segregation is not happening from the household manner? That's, it has to be very strict fine
I
for
agree
the household.
With you. I agree with you, ma'am. But what I'm saying is that I think by saying that segregation is not happening, be mindful of the fact that there are all these slave-like people who are treated by slaves, by all those who don't segregate, who are segregating, so don't undermine their work.
Okay.
It's 60% of plastic. No. My point is segregation from the home.
I'm talking to
okay.
her.
It has to be segregation from the home. That's how, you know, we have a plastic
but
material.
But I just want to, I'm going to come across to Dr. Dang when we talk about, you know, recycling medical waste. But first, you've touched upon an important point. You're saying you're willing to pay for this, right? I want to ask a question. Anyone here who would like to respond, does the burden, will this burden of this plastic ban, if it happens, then not disproportionately affect the poor over the better well-off, right? These sachets, shampoo sachets, soap sachets, a poor person can't afford to buy a 120 rupee, I don't know, 500 mg shampoo bag, but you can buy 5 rupees of a sachet every time. Will the poor be disproportionately affected? Here, give it here.
Well, firstly, there's going to be a cost. And if there's already a cost, the earth is bearing the cost right now. So let's not bluff ourselves saying there's no cost. And we all have to be willing to bear the cost because somebody, and actually the poor, are bearing the cost of our lavish lifestyles, of our extravagant ways, of our convenience lifestyles.
Yes.
And I think we need to bear that in mind, that people are bearing the cost. We are getting affected by it because all of a sudden we're seeing that we're going to be pinched by this, by the higher rises of plastic rates and so on. But the poor have traditionally, all the years, borne the cost of our lavish lifestyles, and the earth has borne the brunt. And right now, the same, there's a crisis. I'm very surprised that the panelists are talking about maybe option one, option two. There is no option. We are on a crisis point. Everything, not only plastic bans. I'm surprised that you're only talking about plastic banning right now. You've got to look at everything coming into focus right now. Budgets have to be rescheduled. As laws that we reschedule, and everything should come to place.
Okay,
as a crisis
but, the poor pay the price. We have inequality in the country where the rich, we are all using air conditioning, and then, you know, we're going to have to give that up if we want to,
absolutely,
you know, tackle climate change. But we're a poor country, a developing country, when it comes to the Europe and the US. We have, I think, 11 kg per capita consumption of plastic. The global average is 28 kgs. In America, it's 109 kgs. But that said, they do more waste segregation and recycling than we do.
No.
So we contribute more
India's,
when it comes
India's
to...
India's recycling rate is much higher than the US in the global average. India's recycling rate is 60% plus. And if you go by specific plastics, such as PET, it's even above 80%. So, you know, we need to understand when we talk about people or children being well informed, I doubt if children even know that there are various kinds of plastics. You know how this plastic has to be identified versus other plastics? So some amount of literacy, people generally know, do a Google and, you know, call plastics. But that there are various kinds of plastics, each has a different kind of recycling propensity and, you know, properties, is not known commonly. And that probably industry does need to pick up and educate the masses. That will probably be the right
solution. I think dumped its plastics on us, on Malaysia, on Pakistan, on Bangladesh. And now that we're banning it, they can't even recycle
it. This bottle gives me an idea why it is also important to reduce it. Because instead of drinking water through a pearl pit bottle, I can understand it's Coke. But you see, if you go by the mandate of all the municipalities, because I've served a municipality for 5 years, all the municipalities have a mandate of providing clean, potable water.
Yes.
So you see, it has to be integrated. You can't just understand things in silos. So if your water is potable and there is an answerability, there is an onus, responsibility on somebody, why should we
drink from this?
Yeah, for that matter.
Because it's fashionable,
stations.
Maybe now it's fashionable
reduction,
to actually drink
so you
in
say
a
this
carry
whole strategy
away.
That we're talking about, recycling, also reduction of the waste. I mean, why can't we reduce it? Say we are consuming 100 bottles, so I can
reduce
to 10.
Less, consume less. Yes. We have to all do that. Dr. Dang, tubes, syringes, urinary bags, catheters, injections, IV, you know, all of these are also single time, one use, plastics. Obviously, nobody is expecting that they will be on this proposed list of these so-called single-use plastics that one is expecting this government to announce a ban. That would be an extreme step. But this really highlights the conundrum that we're facing, exactly. Right? Plastics are ubiquitous. And they're part of the technological advances that we've seen in the world, the life that we live, the quality of life we have, from heart valves to computers. So where do you stand on this? Representing, you know, the health profession, what would you say?
Well, first, I've been listening to so many different points of view.
Thank
out
you
here.
For listening so patiently.
And patiently. First, I would like to strongly beg to differ with Dr. Hubble.
Okay.
When he said that plastics have been there since the last 50, 60 years, and we have seen no adverse effects happening on the human health.
Yes.
Sir, tobacco was there for hundreds of years before it was found to be carcinogenic.
Hmm.
There's so many instances which I can give you where we did not initially come to know that what were side effects.
Yeah.
Now here, why do we see this? That now every family that I know of is having some person in their family suffering from some malignancy or other.
Yeah.
When I came into this profession about 30, 40 years back, I was told that uske kisi ko cancer hua hai. But now the problem is every family practically seems to be having a malignancy patient. Why? The root cause is the environment. It may be insecticide, pesticide, preservatives, pollution, or things like plastics. Why talk about plastics out here is so commonly used. Even it has been proved that plastic utensils being microwaved, they cause carcinogenics to appear.
Yeah.
Plastics, if water kept in plastic bottle, kept in the sun outside or heated before it reaches our individual homes, that is supposed to be carcinogenic. Wherever you go, plastics, we have to admit to it. And that is why the stand
this
taken.
This is WhatsApp can, University.
Can okay. No. This is finish? A doctor. This is a leading doctor in the country. He's also a representative doctor, chosen by the government or the Medical Council of
fair
India.
Fair enough. You know, with due respect, Sachin Tendulkar is a great cricketer. He cannot talk on dentistry. He could be a medical doctor, but when he says that there are instances of carcinogen or anything, are there any a single paper which you know?
There are many
paper?
Many studies. Not. There's just a recent study out from the institute in Bangalore that says pollution is the cause for the increasing number of heart attacks. I don't need to fight your case, Dr. Dang. Go
I
for it.
I think I need to first then come to your answer. That was what my submission, humble submission, was. That yes, plastics are not safe. Something has to be done to them. That they are not a part of a routine daily life. But on the other hand, when it comes to the medical profession, please understand that we are surrounded by plastics. We cannot do without them.
Yes.
When a patient enters the hospital, the first thing is a syringe.
Yes.
Which is plastic, the needle, plastic hub,
the tube,
drip, plastic drip, bag, the IV fluid with the stored, plastics, the chemical, the reagents, the medicine we get, plastic bottles. The region which I import from abroad, they all come in big plastic boxes.
Mm.
Again, they're put into thermocol boxes.
Yes.
Ice as preservative when they're being transported, again in plastic wraps. I cannot imagine, on an average in a day, I must be consuming thousands of syringes.
Yes.
Are they not all plastic?
Yes.
They're all single-use plastic. Needle hubs are single-use needle hubs. All things we're talking about. So, I would request, give us a solution before you create the problem. The problem is there. We know the problem. If you ban it,
I think,
how can you ban it without taking and looking into a wider perspective that how it is going to impact the consumer industry, the healthcare industry? I'm concerned about healthcare industry also. Also, I'm saying, because I'm also a human being. I'm also a citizen of India. I also have children. I also have grandchildren. I want their safety also.
Yes.
So it should be, but it cannot be a blanket ban. That just go ahead or kuch bhi ho sab ko ban kar do. Find us, give us a solution.
I think Tikinder said it that you don't need to ban
exactly a year ago exactly
delivery of emergency goods during the floods. Exactly. You don't need to ban medical plastic that you use to save someone's life, but if you remember
exactly a year ago you'd organized a similar show on plastic ban, but that was when we had the World Environment Day.
I saw
on the television countering this argument on the health, whatever devices are required. And they said, let's go back to the basics. Why don't you boil the syringe? And I remember that show was here. I mean, one of the experts.
We are not, Tikinder, we don't do any waste recycling, and you're asking the doctors to boil the syringe. I would rather the doctor use a fresh syringe on me. I don't want to take that chance with my life.
That's not my, but that's what has been happening.
Surely the problem is not with the disposable syringe. Yeah.
No, but that's also made of plastic,
that's
right?
No, I agree.
If it was releasing poison.
Dr. Acharya, please come in over here. Has the government provided us with an alternative before we push for this so-called ban on plastics?
Alternatives will slowly evolve. Number one, there is no need for doing so much of hair splitting discussion on this. First, you reduce using. Start doing it, a new path will slowly evolve. I know it is not clearly visible today. For many things it is there.
Mr. Acharya, the Prime Minister has just come back from the UN. The BJP organized a huge show yesterday welcoming him back home. Dance, cultural performances, they lined the streets for 2 kilometers. Of course, the Prime Minister, India, we believe that we are a world leader now. And so if we are going to be a world leader, we cannot be ignorant and, you know, not make any big moves on climate change. Is that why we've made this big ban? How can we not have an alternative? You're saying they'll just emerge from where? Where will they emerge magically from? The government has to provide the alternative, sir.
One minute. Alternatives are available. Suppose instead of using plastic glasses, you can go in for stainless steel glasses. One company, Anand Kumar, former minister's wife, has kept around
30,000
steel glasses. Anybody who wants a stainless steel glass can collect from their house free of charge. Such services will be available in future also. Now, segregation is happening.
This is not the government providing it, sir. That's me carrying my own stainless steel glass. That is, yes, so let personal consumption,
no,
sir,
that is okay,
my
but
awareness.
Now segregation is happening. Segregation was not happening in the past at all.
Once you start a way of doing it, it will happen. Every time you wash
them. You only give chances.
Water will be wasted.
So now the ban is
and
only for thin plastic.
And on the one hand, you are talking of water stress. You have created a Jal Ministry for that thing. So we are under water stress, huge water stress. The next decade, in fact, next few years are going to be water starvation years. And you want to promote, you know, all these kinds of fanciful things which we came away from. Because every time this community thing comes, hygiene is big problem. You never know when the waiter comes in the community
Bharati,
service.
You have to admit, you know, the argument being made here is that there's an opportunity cost of everything. Everything has a cost, there's a carbon footprint for everything.
Washing
are we making an informed
problem.
Decision? Is this government making an informed decision is the question.
So here are four things. First of all, I think we ban or we phase out in phases. There are easier things and there are harder things.
Yes.
And there are the hardest things. Yeah. And
so
I
the low-hanging fruit should go first
because I think it's not only about getting rid of the low-hanging fruit. Consumers have to get used to it. The second thing I think that's really important is to detoxify existing plastics. Now, in the medical world, a lot of it is PVC with a lot of toxic additives. Now, can we put R&D as a country and find other kinds of additives or so that we have detoxified materials while for emergencies? Because we don't want phthalates in our bloods. I mean, that's a problem. And in fact, Dr. Dang previously gave me amazingly positive information. He was saying that all these scrubs that are now of woven plastic, they're useless. And the good old-fashioned kapde ka jo doctors used to wear, ironed and laundered, are far more hygienic and sterile, which is a great piece of information and we should propagate it. But the third thing I think we need to do is to really invest in R&D. We put in so much knowledge
into IT.
That
is the government's job. Where is the government?
Not just government.
We're expecting a ban to be announced, but where's the R&D?
There is
some R&D. It's going to come after the ban is announced?
No, let's start with phase one ban. Let's run the R&D, let's run the trials, go to phase two, let this be a multi-year kind of thing. And I think the fourth thing finally is extended producer responsibility. Let's get out from the ecosystems the kinds of plastic polymer materials that are being there. We work a lot in Uttaranchal. I cannot begin to describe to you how the furthest forest and the furthest bird is eating Maggi noodles packaging. Mm. It's disgusting, it's frightening, it's appalling, but most of all, it's really irresponsible.
Correct. The producers have to take responsibility. After the break, I want to go across to Jayesh Rambeya, who represents the All India Plastic Manufacturers Association. In the end, it's up to the public. Whatever Dr. Hebo is saying here, it's up to you. You have to reject their products. If you reject their products, they will come up with alternatives. We'll go across to Mr. Rambeya after a short break to represent the Plastic Manufacturers Association. Thanks. All right, welcome back, Jayesh Rambeya. Yes, this move will have an impact, economic impact, at a time when we're in an economic downturn. But as Greta Thunberg says, the time to panic has come. And the industry, plastic industry, has enjoyed a great run for decades. Perhaps now it is time to be more responsible and sustainable. Your response?
Industry has grew thanks to government is making 45% polymer in this country is made by the government plastic PSUs. India is exporting plastic to 140 countries, advanced countries, where it is considered safe by FDA, by European Association or European Authority. Even Food Safety and Standard Association of Authority of India considers plastic safe for packaging of food and pharma. So first we should address, don't spread wrong fears without giving proper alternative, without proper study. One paper coming somewhere, you cannot take it as standard, because if plastic was unsafe, the government cannot be packing dairy, milk in plastic. So first, plastic unsafe, if government says unsafe, I'll believe
Sir,
it's unsafe.
Sir, the governments have not been known to do many things paper. That have been unsafe for the public. That is not an argument I'm willing to accept.
No, but when it is safe in Europe, when it's safe in US, when it's safe world over, what happens to it
Many
when it comes to India?
World over are
What's
now
happening
banning,
in your
city? Are now banning plastic, sir.
Not for safety. Wherever in the world you go, you will find food and pharma
yes,
packed in
not
plastic.
Arguing
so
about
first
safety
remove
right
that
now.
Fear.
We're talking about the fact
no,
that
Dr. Deng was saying about safety.
And
so,
this
okay,
waste
now that non biodegradable ban.
Disappear.
So, in Europe, they have SUP as a different meaning, single-use packaging.
Yes.
Sarva Dravya Samabhav. So whatever material the package is made of need to be recycled. You cannot single
okay,
out plastic and not recycle
done
metal,
anything
glass
to push
or paper.
For recycling. Over the past few decades, have you not, why has the industry not taken a step to do this? Why are you crying foul today, 3 days before a ban is going to be announced?
Plastic waste management rules were announced by government in 2016. And there were various responsibilities given to municipalities, to Department of Petrochemical and Chemical, to Urban Department, everybody, government, all government authorities and brand and plastic processor.
Okay. We're talking
the National
about
Green
the
Tribunal
impact.
Has
we have
fined
somebody here.
25
you
states.
Run a company
no, hold on.
That works
yes. hold
with
on,
plastic.
Madam.
Yes.
Hold on, madam. A second.
Quickly,
25
sir,
states have been fined.
Left.
25 states have been fined by NGT for not following government rules. We cannot go out and collect waste. Whatever waste comes to us, we recycle. India is recycling 60%, which is highest in the world. What we are requesting is, whatever government decides, you should compensate the unit which are closing as policy-affected people, the way you would compensate a project-affected people. And that is very fair and very just
okay,
demand.
Why are you agreeing with what sir is saying here?
Actually, to be very frank, the impact on the industry, if we are talking about, there are the four processes. There is injection molding, extrusion, blow molding, and one more process, thermoforming.
Okay.
All the industries are going to have the impact if they are going to be the ban on the single-use plastic. And as they said rightly,
yes, sir, there's going to be a cost we have to pay as a civilization,
no, actually,
as humanity.
The 60-70% of the plastic can be recycled easily. Okay, so this is the government. This is the government.
But just two or three times, not more than that.
Not more than
no,
that.
No, of course so it can be. Of course it can be. There are the processes.
Every industry,
you can
there is a
use
cycle.
The catalyst to reprocess it.
So every industry has a cycle, right? 30 years ago, 40 years ago, let's say the glass industry was sitting here. Somebody representing the glass industry was sitting here and saying that, look, he's going to have to not employ many workers, just like you're complaining today.
No, we are
a life cycle for your industry. Times have changed.
No, it's not like that, because you see there are 70 million people are employed with the plastic industry right now.
Yes, so, and this is an opportunity. Is there an economic opportunity now? Any closing arguments quickly? I'm going to pass the mic on. My question is this also not an opportunity for other industries? R&D, this just as if we're seeing unemployment in the plastic industry, maybe we'll see employment somewhere else, whoever discovers this, you know, alternative to plastic.
Yes, government has the alternative, but there's no plan. Just like the demonetization, government came up with a demonetization, but the government didn't come up with a plan, actually execution. So the people have to suffer.
So the people will suffer. I think we're going to end on that note. Hopefully that is not the case, that the government does actually have a plan. While we all agree, I think, that we need to take some tough steps. Thank you for joining us on We the People tonight. It's a show where we believe it's important to speak up, but it's also important to listen. And I think we did that tonight. Thank you all. Thank you and good night. Thank you.